Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to another theory video hosted by me, Alex, at the Disney Pixar Connection. Oops, super excited. We are doing Iron Man theory. We are on a roll with these theory videos. We're on a roll with our Marvel. There is so much Marvel content coming out, TV shows, movies, in the next 3 years. I know I'm going to do a Marvel update because they did release that on Disney Day, and that was months ago, and I never did the video, so that'll be catching up. Anyway, let's talk Iron Man. So, in the Endgame, I know this is hard. In the Endgame, he died. I'm not trying to give things away, okay? Look, the Endgame's been out for years at this point. Don't hate me, but Tony Stark, Iron Man, he is dead. He's dead, unfortunately. But I have some interesting theories on this. So now, I know he was our first hero. I know he was beloved, annoying, rich superhero, because he was. But, oh my gosh. Okay, so he sacrificed himself in the Endgame. We knew that in Iron Man, between Iron Man 1, when he became, during Iron Man, when he originally became Iron Man because of the whole situation where he was taken in Afghanistan, and then he had to create this thing, and he created, whatever. Anyway, in Iron Man 2, we find out he's dying, and that other people are trying to replicate his suit, right? And his friend, Rhodes, took one of the other suits. So I'm going to say this. It is possible that someone else, because often a lot of superheroes in these comics get replaced by just a new person in that role. It happens with Green Lantern. It happens with Captain America, for example. There's just a whole bunch, right? It does happen. So, especially because it's not like he had some magical power. I hate to say that. But he created his power. Kind of like we were talking about Batman in Moon Knight. Iron Man wasn't born with magic. It's not like he was bit by a spider and something magically happened like in Spider-Man either. He created his power through his work, his technology, and his money. So anyone could technically replace him. I know, don't hate me, just saying. Rhodes would be a good person. And honestly, I wouldn't hate if like Terrence Howard came back as Rhodes, because I think that would be kind of cool, but it would be kind of confusing because Don Cheadle's been Rhodes for a while now. Don't know why they replaced him. That's kind of annoying. Anywho, sorry, just being picky about that. So it's possible that Rhodes steps up, but also in the Endgame, we saw Pepper, I'm gonna say Peppa, but Pepper, who eventually became his wife and had the baby. They have a little girl together. And we see their development through, you know, the timeline. I think that's really cute. She was also in a suit. She came in and kicked ass with the women. Like, first of all, that scene was fantastic. I loved it. I want to see more of that. As a female, I love the representation. But so that could also be a thing. Maybe they're going to keep it in the family. We also saw a clip before his passing where his daughter was like, oh, here's the Iron Man helmet. Like, what's this? And I think she was wearing it at one point. It's been a hot minute since I've watched the film, but, and that was during the Endgame, the beginning of Endgame, I think. So yeah, that's something that could be, but let's just go check out when he sacrificed himself.
Thank you.
So that was in Endgame, right? So that was after Infinity War. However, in Infinity War, when the snap originally happened, right? So that was what set off the Endgame. They were trying to fix it because when Thanos did the, which I'm about to show you, look what happens. We see who goes and who stays. And when I say who goes, during that 5-year span where before they could fix it, because that's the time between the end of Infinity Wars and Endgame, when they're fixing it, they're going back in time and they're. Anyway, the whole premise of the Endgame is the Avengers, the rest of the Avengers working to fix this. It's quite interesting who ends up going because of the way that Marvel has been releasing the films. So check out this. This is exactly when the snap happened, and this is what was happening. So, yeah, so we noticed Groot, Black Panther, and WandaVision all in that scene all disappeared. Oh, and Spider-Man. Certain people who have upcoming or have had upcoming movies and shows in the lineup are the ones that disappeared. Now, granted, Thor does have something coming up in, I mentioned in the Thor Theory. I believe it's 2023. And also, after that happened, Captain America. Yeah, Captain America retired at the end of the movie. But, oh, Winter Soldier. Bucky Barnes, he also disappeared. He had the show Falcon and the Winter Soldier. So quite an interesting perspective. I have yet to see people talk about this, and this movie came out a while ago. So what's up with that, MCU? Just saying. Anyway, so I want to show you some other clips to talk about because I really do think that there's something about the funeral, this particular scene of Tony Stark's funeral is talked about because one, who is going to take over as Iron Man, and two, there's certain people that showed up at the funeral, and you're like, who are they? How are they connected to MCU? So let's see the clip because interesting. Okay, so we see a lot of the same characters are back after the 5-year snap, which makes sense because we know that happened. WandaVision was really big proof of that. I find it interesting that Wanda is there herself. Vision is not. So, okay, interesting. But Wanda is there, and it's quite interesting because after the 5-year snap before the end game, before the official death of no, now I'm confused. Y'all, this has me thinking. When there's a glitch in this. There's a mistake somewhere. Now that I'm thinking, I have to rewatch this. Wanda is back. Wanda went on a rampage with her show. What the hell is going on? Anywho, maybe she came back for his I don't know. I need to clearly think about this. I think there's going to be a part two to this theory. Because now it has me thinking. Anyway, the guy, the kid before Captain Marvel was on the stairs was the kid that Iron Man saved during, I believe it was Iron Man 3. So that's interesting that he showed up. Then we have Captain Marvel, who's kind of separated from the group. Why is that? Why are they in certain groups? Notice that. And then, of course, Nick Fury. Nick Fury, Nick Fury, Nick Fury. Nick Fury and Agent, God, why can I not think of his name? Carlson? Carl something, whatever his name is. He's the head of Agent Shield. If you watch that movie, watch that show, sorry, the show, you'll know who I'm talking about. He does show up in the movies, though. I feel like they're the glue, right? So first it was Fury who gave him his job, and then he took over the whole thing. There are quite a number of other Marvel theories out there. I'd love to hear what your thoughts are. But yeah, quite interesting, don't y'all think? I don't know. Anyway, I was showing you all this because obviously he's clearly dead. So who do you think is going to become the new Iron Man? I'm really vying between Rhodes and Pepper. I'm having a brain fart. Who do you think is going to become? Or do you think it's going to be something else? I have honestly not read up on the Iron Man comics yet. So bear that in mind. I don't actually know what the comics say, and I'm not going to use that. But again, I will be back with an Iron Man theory part 2, because I do have more questions on this. I hope to see you guys next time. I get to read your comments. If you like this video, please give me a like and subscribe, and I will see you very soon.